parade, bringing with it excitement and emotion that can be found in no other sporting event. The NCAA tournament. The wait is finally over, the brackets are ready, and the drama of March Madness is about to begin. Hello everyone, I'm Greg Gumbel, and this is the NCAA Championship Basketball Selection Show, brought to you by State Farm, the number one auto insurer. Joining me at the anchor desk, as always, my partner, Clark Kellogg. We're all set to show you the seedings and pairings, so get out your bracket sheet, get those pencils ready. Here are the basics. Of the 65 available tournament bids, 31 are automatically given to conference champions. The tournament committee hands out the remaining 34 bids on an at-large basis. But before we unveil the brackets for this season, here's a look at the final top 25 media poll of the season. The rankings look a little different than they did last week. One team made a huge move in the poll. The Clemson Tigers jumped all the way from the number 18 spot to number 9.
They're peaking at just the right time, Greg. This is exactly the way you want to be playing going into the tournament.
Also, a new team has made the leap into the top 25. The Alabama Crimson Tide break into the poll as the number 20 team. And that puts a cap on the final top 25 poll of the year. Now let's take a look at the NCAA tournament bubble and see which teams are sitting at home with their fingers crossed, hoping to see their name in the brackets. There are a lot of worthy candidates among these 10 teams, Clark. Which of these bubble teams stands out to you right now?
The Washington Huskies impressed me this year, but there were occasions when they seemed to lose focus for a game or two at a time. And those setbacks could be what keeps them out of the tournament.
Point well taken, but they're not the only team sweating it out right now.
The Memphis Tigers should be considered among the best of the major conference teams not holding an automatic bid. But there are plenty of non-power...
The top five teams up top are all ACC.
...prevent them from getting an invitation.
I'm sure it's been a long week for those teams, but the wait, the Villanova Wildcats are the top overall seed, and they will play in the Charlotte Regional. They begin the tournament as the dominant team in college basketball. They've been ranked number one in the media poll for the past 2 weeks. We'll soon find out if they can live up to their billing. On to the second number one seed, who will play in the San Antonio Regional. The Kansas Jayhawks are seeking their third NCAA championship in school history. The Florida Gators are our third number one seed, and they'll play in the Minneapolis Regional. They're back in the tournament again, and no doubt they'll be feeding off the experience of last year's appearance as they try to get to the Final Four this year. And finally, our fourth number one seed will play in the Atlanta Regional. The West Virginia Mountaineers are in the tournament field as a number one seed for the second time in the history of their program. Now, here's how the brackets shape up based on where the number one seeds have been assigned. In one national semifinal game, the winner of the Charlotte Regional will play the winner of the San Antonio Regional. In the other semifinal game, the winner of the Minneapolis Regional will play the winner of the Atlanta Regional. Those games will be played on Saturday, April 3rd. Then they'll be on to the national championship game on Monday night, April the 5th. Anything shocking to you about those picks?
Well, when you see the selection committee...
First up, we take a look at the Charlotte Regional. The Villanova Wildcats are the top seed, finishing at 25-6. In the Big East, they will take on the winner of the opening round play-in game between the Delaware Blue Hen with 14 wins and the Norfolk State Spartan from the MEAC. And now, the number 8 seed, the Indiana Hoosiers, come into the tournament 5th in their conference during the regular season and finish 2nd in their conference tournament. They're going to play the number 9 seed, the Kansas State Wildcats, who were 6th in their conference, finishing at 18-11. The South Carolina Gamecocks entered the field as the number 4 seed from the SEC. This marks their 13th appearance in the NCAA tournament in school history. They'll be getting ready to face the number 13 seed. The Siena Saints finished the season with 17 wins. They're the tournament champion from the Metro Atlantic Conference. The UNLV Running Rebels come in as the number 5 seed, finishing at 23-9. And they will take on the 12th seed, the Utah State Aggies from the WAC, with 17 wins. Next up is the number 2 seed. The Clemson Tigers are the conference tournament champions from the ACC. They'll be going up against the number 15 seed, the Tennessee State Tigers, with 18 wins. This will be their 5th appearance. Our number 7 seed is from the Big East. The Seton Hall Pirates were rewarded for their outstanding play.
Lost the Big East championship game to Miami.
Ticket to the Big Dance. They are going to play the number 10 seed, the Memphis Tigers, who were 6th in their conference, finishing at 20-12. The Baylor Bears are in as the number 3 seed. They'll be taking on the number 14 seed, the Lipscomb Bison, with 18 wins. Oklahoma Sooner are in as the number 6 seed. They'll be taking on the number 11 seed, the Weber State Wildcats, with 25 wins. Some of the lower seeds in this bracket have the ability to not only compete with the high seed, but win a few games. The potential for a Cinderella or two in this bracket is definitely there. Next up, we'll take a look at the seed. The Kansas Jayhawks are the top seed, finishing at 25-8. They finished 12th in the Big 12. They'll take on the Idaho State Bengals, the number 16-ranked team. This marks their 16th appearance in the NCAA tournament in team history. The San Francisco Dons are in as the number 8 seed. They'll be taking on the number 9 seed, the Iowa State Cyclones, with 19 wins. The Utah Utes come in as the number 4 seed, finishing at 21-10. They'll take on the 13th seed, the Long Beach State 49ers from the Big West, with 18 wins. The Oklahoma State Cowboys enter the field as the number 5 seed from the Big 12. It's yet another appearance in the brackets for a school that's no stranger to the NCAA tournament. They'll be getting ready to face the number 12 seed, the Stanford Cardinals. Finished the season with 23 wins. They're the tournament champion from the Pac-10. Our number 2 seed is from the ACC. The Louisville Cardinals had a tremendous year that included a regular season championship. They're going to play the number 15 seed, the Citadel Bulldogs, who came in first in their conference tournament, finishing at 18-8. Next up is the number 7 seed, the USC Trojans, have established themselves as one of the best teams from the Pac-10. They'll be going up against the number 10 seed, the East Carolina Pirates, with 23 wins. This is their 6th appearance in the NCAA tournament. The Creighton Blue Jays are in as the number 3 seed. They'll be taking on the number 14 seed, the Loyola Marymount Lions, with 21 wins. And now the number 6 seed, the Nevada Wolfpack, come into the tournament first in their conference during the regular season and finish second in their conference tournament. They are going to play the number 11 seed, the Colorado State Rams, who came in first in their conference tournament, finishing at 25-10. What a tremendous regional final we'd have in this bracket if the number 1 and 2 seeds here make it through the first 3 rounds unscathed. That could be one of the games of the tournament. On to our 3rd bracket of the day. The Florida Gators are the top seed, finishing at 25-6. In the SEC, they'll take on the Southern Jaguars, the number 16-ranked team. This marks their 10th appearance all time. Our number 8 seed is from the Sun Belt Conference. The Louisiana Lafayette Raging Cajuns had a tremendous year that included a regular season championship. They're going to play the number 9 seed, the North Carolina Tar Heels, who were 7th in their conference, finishing at 19-12. The Alabama Crimson Tide enter the field as the number 4 seed from the SEC. It's yet another appearance in the brackets for a school that's no stranger to
Alabama, the defending champs.
They'll be getting ready to face the number 13 seed, the Eastern Washington Eagles. Finished the season with 19 wins. They're the regular season and tournament champions from the Big Sky. The Alabama Birmingham Blazers are in as the number 5 seed. They'll be taking on the number 12 seed, the Tribe of William and Mary, with 20 wins. The Auburn Tigers are in as the number 2 seed. They'll be taking on the number 15 seed, the Sam Houston State Bearcats, with 16 wins. Next up is the number 7 seed. The Virginia Tech Hokies have established themselves as one of the best teams from the Big East. They'll be going up against the number 10 seed, the Oregon State Beaver, with 22 wins. They return once more to the very familiar surroundings of the NCAA tournament. And now the number 3 seed, the Maryland Terrapins, come into the tournament on the strength of a 3rd place finish in their conference regular season and were semifinalists in their conference tournament. They are going to play the number 14 seed, the Arkansas State Indians, who came in first in their conference tournament, finishing at 18-10. The Syracuse Orange come in as the number 6 seed, finishing at 20-7. And they take on the 11th seed, the St. Joseph's Hawks, from the Missouri Valley Conference, with 26 wins. There are going to be some incredible matchups in the later rounds of this bracket. If the top seeds can avoid the early upsets, we can look forward to some real heavyweight battles. And finally, the West Virginia Mountaineers are the top seed, finishing at 23-7. In the Big 12, they'll take on the Lafayette Leopards, the number 16-ranked team. This will be their 5th appearance in the NCAA. Next up is the number 8 seed, The Rutgers Scarlet Knights are the regular season champion from Conference USA. They'll be going up against the number 9 seed, the Pittsburgh Panthers, with 23 wins. They return once more to the very familiar surroundings of the NCAA tournament. The Ohio State Buckeyes are in as the number 4 seed. They'll be taking on the number 13 seed, the Valparaiso Crusaders, with 16 wins. The UCLA Bruins come in as the number 5 seed, finishing at 21-10. And they will take on the 12th seed, the Wichita State Shockers, from the A-10 conference, with 23 wins. The Michigan State Spartans enter the field as the number 2 seed from the Big Ten. It's yet another appearance in the brackets for a school that's no stranger to the NCAA tournament. They'll be getting ready to face the number 15 seed, the Mountaineers of Mount St. Mary. Finished the season with 17 wins. They're the tournament champion from the Northeast Conference. And now the number 7 seed, the Illinois Fighting Illini, come into the tournament finishing 7th. The Providence Friars are in as the number 3 seed. They'll be taking on the number 14 seed, the East Tennessee State Buccaneers, with 18 wins. Our number 6 seed is from the Pac-10, the Arizona State Sun Devils, were rewarded for their outstanding play this season with an at-large bid and a ticket to the big game. They are going to play the number 11 seed, the Miami Hurricanes, who came in first in their conference tournament, finishing at 23-11. On the surface, I'd have to say this regional might be the most difficult of the four. Certainly the depth of quality teams here is very impressive. Whoever emerges from this bracket will have been through some battles. Clark, give us your take on the tournament's top 16 seeds.
There are no real off-the-wall picks that jump out at. These 16 teams are all pretty deserving. Let's give the committee some props this year. The Baylor Bear, as a 3 seed, probably won't scare too many people in the field. I'd rather have to face them than a few of the teams that are seeded 5 and 6.
Now, let's bring the conference picture into focus. The Big 12 gets 17. The Big 10 with 6. 6 out of the Big East. The ACC gets 16. The Pac-10 with 5. 4 out of the SEC.
What a down year for the non-power conference.
Here's the list of the teams that were on the bubble heading into Selection Sunday. So, partner, which of those invitees should be sending the selection committee a thank you card?
Pittsburgh Panthers can finally exhale. I don't think there was a lot of doubt that they'd make it, but we've seen good teams get left out before, and you just know this was a nerve-wracking day for this squad.
While they start prepping for their first-round games, the 5 teams on the other side of the page will be full-time students again.
The Boston College Eagles stumbled to the finish line coming down the stretch, and that's not the way to close out the season if you're hoping for an at-large bid. When they couldn't get it done in their conference tournament, their goose was cooked.
All right, Clark, now that we know all the teams and matchups, time to get the tournament underway and let the madness take over.
Greg, it's going to be a fantastic tournament. We've got an outstanding field and a lot of sensational players. I guarantee there are some memorable moments soon to come.